right, what's going on, you guys? Nick here with Nick Strength and Power. I've got a couple more interesting stories for you guys today. The second video of the day. Yet again, make sure you guys like the videos if you are enjoying the two videos a day. We've got a physique update for Classic Physique from Alex Cambronero. He goes by Fellow Cambronero on Instagram. This is him at 2 weeks out. Now, Alex Cambronero is an interesting guy to me because at last year's Classic Physique Olympia, he was fifth. The year prior in 2020, he was fourth, and he's also won the Arnold Classic Classic Physique competition. So he really is a top-tier classic guy, but I feel like he's gotten kind of lost in this shuffle with Urs, with Terrence, with Ramon, with Breon. Actually, I'm sorry, let me correct that. He was sixth at last year's Olympia and fourth the year prior, not fifth. So last year he did get beaten by Urs, by Ramon, by Breon, by Terrence. But with all these new guys, he's kind of gotten lost in the conversation. And also because of the fact we haven't seen him compete since last year's Olympia. He hasn't been as active. I haven't seen as many updates from him on social media as we've been seeing from Urs and from Ramon and from Terrence. And I think for that reason, his name has gotten lost in translation. But his placing has been trending downward from fourth in 2020 to sixth in 2021, possibly outside the top six this year. That's the question that I want to see answered this year. And again, with this crop of guys in Classic Physique, you want to talk about a crazy Classic Physique lineup. There's over 60 qualified competitors in Classic, or almost 60. And we thought men's open bodybuilding was competitive with 30 plus. Classic Physique, I feel like it's one of those categories where anything could happen. And I would not be surprised. Now, let's talk about another men's open guy that we haven't really talked about as much during this Olympia buildup, and that is James the Shed Hollingshead, qualifying for the Olympia by winning the Tsunami Pro. And keep in mind, any bodybuilder that qualified for the Olympia off a win is a very dangerous bodybuilder. And he's been known for his conditioning, his grainy conditioning and his grainy look, especially in his Instagram post. But last year at the Olympia, there was a lot of hype behind James for this same reason. He's got this really grainy, hard look on Instagram, and he does win shows. But he's got this crazy look on Instagram, crazy lighting, and then it didn't really translate to the Olympia stage, and last year he took 12th place. And keep in mind, last year, I believe there was only 16 competitors total, so he was 12th out of 16. So he was really towards the end of that Olympia lineup, towards the bottom, you could say. And this year, like I said, there's around 30 guys that we know are probably doing it, 36 total are qualified. So that just gives you some perspective here. I mean, this Olympia lineup has almost twice the guys of last year, maybe more. And like I said before, I only know of four or maybe five of those guys that are qualified out of the 36 that aren't doing it. And of course, I didn't have James in my top 10 predictions. I am very curious to see where he's going to land. If he was 12th last year, it would be really impressive for him to be 12th again this year, to have that same placing, I think would be an accomplishment for him, because I think this is a much deeper lineup. So if he were to stay the same in terms of placings, I think that would be tremendous. If he were able to crack the top 10, that would be huge for him. But I'm really not expecting a conversation around the top six for James this year, even though I do think he's a phenomenal bodybuilder. And again, James is another guy that really speaks to the true depth of this lineup. We're talking about guys like James, like Blessing, like Hassan. And we're talking about them as not being potential factors in the top 10. That's how good this lineup is, and I think we should all be appreciative that we have something so competitive to watch this year. This is going to be a good one. Now, next up in the news, another story that's been going kind of viral across the bodybuilding and fitness Instagram pages is NPC Nationals. And we see this happen, it seems like every year, whether it's at the Nationals or another higher quality show, or maybe even the Arnold Classic Amateur, you see a competitor that's blatantly out of shape and people get mad. And people, one of the reasons I don't like to share these stories or say the competitor's name is because the competitor gets bullied a lot. Now, I agree with the general sentiment that at a national level show where pro cards are given out, this isn't a good representation of the sport. And you don't want to see this on a national stage like that because it's kind of insulting to the competitors that actually did the work. Now, that being said, I don't think that this person should be barred from competing in bodybuilding, even if he showed up looking like this at whatever local show or wherever. But the fact of the matter is, he was nationally qualified. So that's the dilemma that they have, is they can't really just turn people away and say, you don't look good enough to be on our stage, even though that person qualified. So if you go to the rules, to be able to compete in an open class at NPC Nationals, You must have competed in and placed top five in an NPC national level or IFBB professional league qualifying contest, such as Junior Nationals, USA's, Universe, North Americans, Arnold Amateur, which I think that might have been where this guy came from, USA's, Nationals, Olympia, Amateur. So all this guy did, probably took fifth at whatever show to qualify for Nationals. So he did qualify. So I think the answer is not to say you're out of shape, you can't compete. I think the answer might be to tighten up the qualification a little bit, because I'm sure it wasn't that difficult for him to place top five at whatever show that he did. And he could have also placed top two in any NPC national qualifying contest, or placed top two in any 2022 NPC national qualifying open contest. Now, this guy did compete in the super heavyweight category, and I think obviously that was a fitting category for him, but the issue is not the embarrassment for this guy being on stage. I think he should be embarrassed enough. I mean, likely he's seeing all these posts on Instagram and stuff talking about him, so I'm sure he's already gotten embarrassed, which is why I don't like talking about this and saying the guy's names. But I do think it should be pointed out that I think the real issue is, if this guy is allowed to compete at Nationals, is there is a chance he gets a pro card. The top two in each class gets a pro card at Nationals, not just the winner. So if we had a situation where he competed in the super heavyweight class, and this would be a pretty rare situation, and nobody else showed up but him and one other guy, he would get a pro card. And that, I think, is the real risk in having someone like this compete at Nationals, because there is a chance that if not enough people show up, they could get a pro card. So I'm curious to hear what you guys think about this in the comment section below. I've seen a lot of conversation about this on Instagram already. And really, like I said, I think we don't want a situation where these bodybuilding contests are turning people away and saying, you don't look good enough to compete in my show, especially at the amateur level. Everybody starts somewhere. We want to see everybody be able to compete. But I think the issue is, I think these qualification standards for Nationals might be a little bit too lax if someone like this is able to qualify for essentially the most prestigious amateur competition in the world. And it's like I said, it's not like this is a one-off thing. We've seen this happen at multiple high-level amateur shows. So clearly there is some kind of loophole laxness to these qualification standards, because there's some people that have been slipping through the cracks lately on these live-streamed big national shows. And we notice, bodybuilding fans notice, and bodybuilding fans are ruthless, and I think they always point it out. But also, I mean, shout out to this guy for having the confidence to get on stage, regardless of the optics of it and regardless of how it made the other competitors feel that really did diet and prepare for this show like a top-level amateur bodybuilder would have. Now, next up in the news, Shaun Clarida, your former 212 Mr. Olympia champion, posting a 14-day-out update with his coach Matt Jansen. Looking pretty good. I think Shaun looks pretty on track. He's known for his conditioning. I think his shot at maybe regaining his title is really good this year. He's got to go up against Kamal, who is also a former 212 Olympia title holder. But Derek Lunsford, the guy that beat him, is noticeably absent this year. Gives him a great opportunity to try to win that title back. Of course, Shaun Clarida did have the option to compete in either open or 212, but they would not let him compete in both. So we're only seeing him in 212 this year, which I do think was the right call for him. Strategically, he will do much better in 212 and potentially win than he would in open bodybuilding, because realistically, he's got a real shot at winning the 212 Olympia. And as much as I like him and I like his physique, I think he's got no shot at winning the men's open Olympia, none. Regardless of how conditioned he comes in, that would not be enough to win the open Olympia. I think he would have a shot maybe at the top six, but a shot to win, I think he would have absolutely none. So him staying in 212, I think, is the right play for him. But as always, let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Make sure you like and subscribe for more videos just like this one, and I'll see you in the next one. As always, I love you guys. Appreciate you guys. Nick Strength and Power signing out. All right, guys, don't forget to click that like button and subscribe to this channel if you enjoy the content. Also, check out my Instagram at Nick Strength Power. My Facebook page, which is simply Nick Strength and Power. My secondary YouTube channel, Nick Strength and Vlogs, for vlogs and bonus content that you will not see on this channel. And consider subscribing to my third YouTube channel, Nick Strength and Pokemon, which is all things Pokemon and trading card games, completely unrelated to this channel. So if you're into that, give that one a look. And all links to merchandise and social media will be in the description box below. If you guys want a Nick Strength and Power t-shirt, that will be in the Shopify link below. Have a great day.